Okay, so I've got time for one more. This is much, much newer. This is an essay, and this is accidentally really similarly formatted. That doesn't really matter, but yeah, so this is a bit more personal than I usually go in public, and yeah, so, and it does not have a title. My wife used to eat books. How fucking poetic is that? She liked the old ones best, she told me, because the paper had more substance between her teeth. It's like a metaphor made flesh and pulp. There are other less literal ways to consume books. I approached my own childhood like a performance, like a job. I read books about kids my age. I extrapolated and went through the motions. I remember holding a box of 84 crayons that I hoarded and used only in margins and staring at the blank white walls until I reached a compromise and took a brown crayon and ran it carefully along the cracks in my wood floor. It wasn't quite what kids did, but it was close enough, I figured. Mostly, though, I read. I read and reread voraciously, sucking my teeth for scraps of language of context. I read like kids with pica eat wood chips and clay, hungry for whatever missing vital mineral would shape me into something solid and real. They say you are what you eat. I didn't have a clear self-image until my early 30s. Ask me to draw myself, and you'd get a lopsided pair of glasses, maybe a messy scribble of hair. The person looking back from photos and mirrors never quite connected, not fully. So I turned to books instead, assembled myself like a composite sketch from fleeting moments of recognition. That's the quirk of my mouth. This is how I hold my hands. I clipped quotations and comics panels. I cataloged and hoarded every possibility. This was my face for a few seconds once. This might be my voice for an instant, someday. Recently, I was invited to give a talk as part of a prestigious lecture series at a prestigious university that would never have admitted me as a student. Nothing leaves me feeling quite so small and shabby and invisible and fractured as recognition. Who do you think I am? I wanted to ask. Who do you want to stand on the stage and talk about what? The theme of the lecture series is stargazing, how dreams shape the world. I watch videos and try to imagine myself with the cool poise of tech wizards and CEOs, and at some point, I realize that I don't know what my voice will sound like come October and whether it will have begun to change. I have never eaten a book, but I do read them a lot and sometimes aloud. My wife and I read each other bedtime stories, the books we grew up with. We've done this since we lived 2,000 miles apart. Every story a pin on the map from there to here. This is what I recognized. This is what I wanted. This is what I found. I have never eaten a book, or even a significant part of a book, or even a magazine. But for the last decade and a half, I've read them more or less professionally. As jobs go, mine is so useless it feels almost subversive, a triumph of frivolity in an era of frantic pragmatism. I am an editor and a writer and a consultant, but right now I mostly make a living explaining comic book continuity, specifically the X-Men. I do this weekly, in an apartment in Queens, into a microphone that connects to a computer that connects to something I don't really understand, but which I do know was invented by Hedy Lamarr. And that connects to my ex-husband's computer and headphones and microphone, which are in Oregon in a house where I used to live. Choose any variable of my life right now, and one thing will hold fairly firm. This is not what I expected to be doing. This is not where I expected to be. I didn't come out for a long time after I knew, or let myself admit that I knew. I'd always imagined that if you peeled away the years of social conditioning, you'd get a cipher, a pair of glasses, a messy scribble of hair, maybe some strong opinions about penmanship. I went to books looking for mirrors, but I never expected to see myself looking back. This is the quirk of my mouth. This is how I hold my hands. This is what I am, and this is its name. I have never eaten written a book, although I've been tempted in the weeks since my wife explained the chewed down edges of a paperback I found while we were unpacking. Call it professional curiosity, maybe, or skipping the middleman. I am half sick of metaphors, the Lady of Shalott, watching the world through her mirror. And that's the end of that. Weird interlude, and now I am turning it over to the real reason that you are all here. Absolutely amazing, phenomenal, spectacular by all their CDs and by the Daniel Sandwich ones too, and she's coming back too, so she's part of this big there. The double clicks. Yeah.